Pastor Jill, the pastor here at Grace Church. You know, many times we forget that we actually have two campuses at this church. We have the campus that comes here on Sunday morning and worships, and we also have the campus on the internet. Anybody ever think of that as a campus? It absolutely is. So wanted to welcome all folks to worship with us, whether you're here or online or whichever campus that you happen to be at. I also want you to take a look around this morning if you are in our worship space, because we do have special guests here today, and I'm hoping that you will greet them as the service unfolds. We will also be having a coffee hour afterwards in the room right next door. So, as far as a couple of quick announcements here, you can read on the back of your bulletin, and if you're online, you can join us at PaynesvilleGrace.org. Did I get that right? PaynesvilleGrace.org, and see some more of these. But we have got the Grace Notes newsletter out, so you can know what's going on this month. We'll be taking down our Christmas decorations come Wednesday, January 11th. We have offering envelopes that are still downstairs that need to be picked up. And you can also take a peek in your bulletin. We have all kinds of new ways of giving. So we have really come into the high-tech world. So check that out. You can even use your phone and scan a barcode and give. I have no idea how that works, but I'm sure someone does. And then Ruth's Circle is going to have their potluck January 10th at noon. Our youth Christmas party is going to be rescheduled, and this time we have prayers that it will not have to be rescheduled again because of our crazy weather. Pardon? It's this Wednesday. All right, thank you, Carrie. And then lastly, we're getting ready to do our new church directories. So please indeed check what it said last year. If you need to make some tweaks, add some information, subtract some information, please let Nancy know that. I believe those were my announcements. Now, before we ring the bell, because we are going to remember to do that this morning, we are going to stand, and you are going to appropriately find someone to touch. And if you're not comfortable with that due to COVID, that's fine. You can just cross your arms. But we are going to bless Bud and Leola as they leave us this week to head off to warmer climates. All right, so everybody stand, because you got to stand for ringing of the bell anyway. Appropriately touch someone. All right, everybody ready? Okay, here comes the blessing. Heavenly Father, we are so excited that you have given us Bud and Leola for the period that you have. We ask that you would give them safe travels, that they would be able to spend time and warm themselves up, and that you would keep them connected to their family and friends here, and that they would be joyful. Amen. 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 Let's have the ringing of the bells. And we're waiting for the ringing of the bells.
Comes up, it's a new day dawn. Bless the Lord, my soul, oh my soul, worship
and join us in a time of prayer. Lord of all eternity, please help me to learn from my mistakes this past year, but not to dwell on them. Please help me not rest on my accomplishments in this past year, but use them to further your work in me and through me. Please help me not to quarrel with those who injured me yesterday, last month, or this past year. Instead, O Father, lead me in your paths and help me see your mighty works this next year. In Jesus' name and by his power, this is what we ask. Please be in a moment and lift up your silent prayers. Lord, we ask that you would take all these prayers that we have spoken out loud and those that we have lifted up silently. We wrap them all up into the prayer that your Son, Jesus, taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Would our children, or those who are still young at heart, please come forward for our children's message. You guys leave room for me down there? Oh, Matthew did. Good job, guys. All right, so who knows what day it is today besides Sunday? It's the 1st of January. It is the new year. And what was yesterday? 2022. So it was the old year. And now we got a new year. So here's something that's kind of interesting. I brought this mirror from my home. So I'm going to have each one of us look in it. Can you see yourself, Matthew? Yep. Okay, there you are. There you are. There you are. And there you are. Can you see yourself? I can see myself. All right. So we can see ourselves and we can look forward. But you know what else a mirror allows us to do? When we look in a mirror, where else can we see? Matthew? You can see backwards, you bet. So now look in the mirror and see if you can see something behind you. Can you see something back there? A window, all right. Can you see something back there?
A tree.
A tree? Another tree. What can you see back there? A light. So here's the most interesting thing about a mirror, and it can happen in a doorway also. Number one, you can see forward, but you can also see backwards. Kind of like the new year. If we look back, we can remember what we did, and then as we think about the new year, we can look forward, just like we did in the mirror. So a little bit later, all these folks out there, plus you guys, are going to help me with another project. Everybody has a piece of paper, and we're going to talk about that a little bit later, what's going to happen with that. Can you help everybody with that project when we come to it? Super. All right, let's have a prayer. Heavenly Father, as we look in our own mirrors and we look forward and we can look backward, let us remember the great God that you have been, the great God that you are today, and the greatest God that you will be tomorrow. Amen. Thanks, you guys. Please pray with me. Heavenly Father, we ask that you would be with us this morning in this worship space, that your Spirit would give each and every one of us the message that you specifically want us to hear. And we ask this in your Son's name. Amen. You know, David, I just have to remember that when you turn those lights on, they are right here, so I have got to remember that I can't see my message. And if I can't see it, you're clearly not going to hear it. Alrighty. So, something that I learned, that I hadn't known, and maybe you guys already know this, is that in the ancient Roman calendar, from which we get our calendar, each month is given a name, a specific name that has a meaning. For example, the month of February. The month of February was named after the feast called Febra, held at that time of the year. March was named after Mars, the god of war. May derived its name from the goddess Maya. June from the goddess Juno. July and August, named, well, respectively, after Julius Caesar and his successor, Caesar Augusta, i.e. August. So that was the deal. That was the deal. Now, those were the naming rights of the 12 months of the calendar. Well, one month was an especially descriptive name, is the one that begins today. The month of January. The Latin word janua derives its name from a door or a window. Something through which we talked about a little bit ago, you can look both ways, forward and backward. You can look in, you can look out, you can look in front of you, and you can look behind you. It means that we stand this morning right here in this space, in the doorway of January, on the precipice of a new year. It means that it makes sense that we would look both directions, backwards and forwards, because that's what's happening in our new year. Now, one of the ways that our culture has of looking back is to make a whole bunch of lists. You've noticed that. There's top 10 lists everywhere. There's a top 10 list for music. There's a top 10 list for songs. There's a top 10 list for video games. There's the 10 top coolest people of the year list. Did you know I was on that list as number one? So here's what the list looks like for 2023. Number one, the top 10 list is people want to exercise more. Number two, they want to eat healthier. Number three, surprise, surprise, they want to lose weight. Number four, they want to save money. Number five, they want to spend time with their friends and with their family. Number six, new on the list, they want to spend less time on social media. Number seven, they want to reduce the stress of the job. Number eight, they want to reduce spending on their living expenses. Number nine, they want to do more good deeds for others. And number 10 this year is people just want to be happy. Be happy. So I don't know about you, but when I read that list and as I've been thinking about it, I think it's rather interesting that as we read that list of top 10 New Year's resolutions, we have to go all the way down to number 9. 9 was do more good deeds for others. We have to go all the way down there to take our focus off ourselves and project it outwards to others. Do more good deeds for others. So now we're going to hear a scripture reading that's going to be coming from John 15. So let's hear how Jesus, teaching and how his talks, talk about how God stays with us as the vine and prunes us, the branches, in order that we might become more fruitful and receive God's abundance.
Good morning. This morning's reading is from John chapter 15, verses 1 through 10. This is from the New Living Translation. Jesus, the true vine. I am the true grapevine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch of mine that doesn't produce fruit, and he prunes the branches that do bear fruit, so they will produce even more. You have already been pruned and purified by the message I have given you. Remain in me, and I will remain in you. For a branch cannot produce fruit if it is severed from the vine, and you cannot be fruitful unless you remain in me. Yes, I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who remain in me and I in them will produce much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me is thrown away like a useless branch and withers. Such branches are gathered into a pile to be burned. But if you remain in me and my words remain in you, you may ask for anything you want, and it will be granted. When you produce much fruit, you are my true disciples. This brings great glory to my Father. I have loved you even as the Father has loved me. Remain in my love. When you obey my commandments, you remain in my love, just as I obey my Father's commandments and remain in his love. This is the word of the Lord.
So you heard it. God does prune the branches that bear fruit so that we will produce even more fruit. Now, the fruitful branches are those of us who are believers, who by living in our union with Jesus Christ, produce much fruit. These branches are like cut back to promote growth. You know, just like those of us who garden, we prune our flowers and our trees and our bushes, and the more we prune, the more they grow back. But what if we put ourselves in the position of not allowing God to prune us? What if we allow ourselves to become unproductive, turning away from God's abundance and separating ourselves from God, the vine? So you all have the blank half a sheet of paper. It came in your bulletin. If you don't have one, if you would please raise your hand and the ushers will give you one. Those of you who are at home, if you would grab some kind of piece of paper. If you're online, please grab a piece of paper. In a few minutes, you're all going to be given a chance to write down one or two things that you need to leave behind in 2023. And we're going to do that in order to make more room to accept God's abundance this year. Now, you may be asking yourselves, really, one or two? I can come up with a whole host of things to fill up that piece of paper. But that's not what we're going to do. We're going to take baby steps, because some of these things may be very challenging. You may need to leave behind worry, an unhealthy habit, the fear of failure, or maybe even not forgiving yourself. Now, even though we may have a difficult time forgiving ourselves, and maybe even a more difficult time forgiving others, God gave us the greatest Christmas present of all times. He gave us His Son, Jesus Christ, and Jesus gives us the gift of forgiveness. And so now we're going to experience that gift of forgiveness. So please join with me in the celebration of Holy Communion. Christ our Lord invites to His table all who love Him, who earnestly repent of their sin, and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved You with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church, and we have not done Your will. We have broken Your law. We have rebelled against Your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So on the evening in which Jesus was with all of His followers, men and women, celebrating the Last Supper, He took the bread and He broke it. He raised it to His Father and blessed it, gave it to all of His followers and said, "Take, eat. This is My body given for you. As you eat it, do not forget Me." And after the supper, He took the wine. He raised it to His Father and it was blessed. He gave it to His disciples and followers and said, "Drink this. This is the blood of the New Testament. The old is gone and the new is here. Take this, drink it, in remembrance of the greatest gift that I gave you all." And that was forgiveness. As we all prepare the table here, please be in a moment of reflection and maybe be thinking about what it is that you're leaving behind. And I will need our ushers to come forward to receive communion, and Helen. Go in peace and serve the Lord. Thank you. blood of Christ shed for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. And the blood of Christ shed for you. And the blood of Christ shed for you. And the blood of Christ shed for you. Go now in peace and be the hands and the feet of Jesus in our new year. Amen.
attention.
Since I missed it, would you all please rise for our closing benediction? And it was the offering. Thank you. How about if you all sit down? I knew it wasn't sounding right, but I was trying to think, how am I going to fix this? Good job. Would our ushers please come forward? That's what I forgot. please join us in our closing song. Shredder over at this back door. We have two paper shredders, one on each door. And the reason we have paper shredders is, I don't know about you, but what I'm leaving behind for 2023 is something very personal. And I do not want other people to know what that might be. So thus, we're going to be putting them in paper shredders so that you too can keep your privacy. For those of you at home or online, obviously you may or may not have a paper shredder, but you can certainly tear yours up and dispose of it that way. So as we depart this place, accept this blessing. Heavenly Father, it is a year where we look behind us and we look ahead. But whatever direction, Lord, that we are looking, we would ask that you would be with us and guide us, and that we could live in all of your abundance. All of your abundance. Amen.